And he's an amazing talent. Please welcome to the stage, John Stevens.
A hand for Anthony up on the sound booth. He's doing great. Yeah. And Nate, who this is his whole brainchild. It's a wonderful thing. I love magic, and one of the things I love about magic is the connections that it makes with different people. The fact that we're all here together for a magic show. It's amazing. It's like a dream of mine as a little kid. I was a geek. It was good. That was good. But no, one of the dances when I was dancing out here is because I can't do that at home. It's not because my wife doesn't like me to dance. She doesn't. But it's not because of that. It's because I have a rescue dog. Yes, I love my rescue dog. The rescue dog does not love me. So anything I do, Ezzy will bark at me. And if I go, she barks at me. So there we are. Now you know a little bit about me. So one of the things when we're doing magic is we have these connection points. Like I will make a coin vanish, and people will tell me, what's the first thing? When I make a coin vanish, what's the first thing you would say where it would be? Up my sleeve. I want to put that to rest. I've got nothing up my sleeve. I need someone to help me. They're gonna be up here for a little bit. You want to help me? All right, come on up. There's stairs. Well, there we are. Hi, how are you? My name's John.
My name's Sammy.
Sammy?
Yeah.
All right, Sammy, come on over. We're going to try something. You're going to help me. Oh, man, 1 second. All right, we're gonna make you a magician. Yeah, you are gonna read one of their minds. It's amazing. I brought a deck of cards and a lead line paper bag. Yes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have someone, let's see, can I have you pick a card? You're not gonna show her, Sammy, because she's gonna be the magician. All right. got the lead line there. Okay, yeah, here I can, so everyone can see it.
Yep.
All right, there we go. I am going, you're gonna put it in the lead line bag. So, no one should get, all right, so, Sammy, what you're gonna do is you're going to look into his eyes. You're gonna look into his eyes and you're gonna read his mind. All right, you're gonna deep into his thought. Well, not that deep. Some into his thoughts, you're gonna see, and you are going to say out loud the card that he merely is thinking of after he picked and showed everybody.
The card is the Queen of Diamonds.
What? I have no idea how she did that.
Amazing.
That's amazing. Wow, that's awesome. All right, so that is our first experiment, but I still want you to stay right here. We are gonna move on to the next one. All right. I have. So when we're reading minds and we are having a moment like this evening, yeah. A lot of it's about connection and it's about noticing things about people that you didn't even know that you noticed. Like, for example, have you ever had it where the phone rings and you know who's on the other line before you pick it up? Caller ID is great. I know. But there are those things that just happens. So we're going to try something. I brought a couple of dice. A red, a white, and a blue dice. It's my patriotic theme. And an old film canister. Long time ago, there were these cameras that you put film in it, and you take... Okay, anyway, never mind. So, we have this film canister. What I'm going to do is I'm going to move over here, out of the way. I'm going to have you take one color of dye. You're going to put the other two back in here. You're going to roll it, and you're going to cover it. That's going to be your number, but you're going to cover it, so I can't see it. All right? Does that make sense? Okay, good. So here's that. I'm going to move over here, look over here. You are going to take one die, put two in the cloth bag. All right? There, two of them were put away. Yes? Okay, and then you're going to roll the other die. Just the one die. Yep, you're going to roll that die. Okay, and you've got it, and you're going to cover it. It's covered?
Yes.
Perfect. Thank you. All right. So I'm gonna step right out over here. So I'm gonna ask you a couple of questions, and we're gonna see if I can read your mind to see what die you used and what number you rolled. Okay? All right. One second. Oh, that's a whole nother rope trick. Sorry. All right. So I'm going to ask you to say red, white, and blue. Okay?
Red, white, blue.
Would you say that you're going to say it backwards? Blue, white, red.
Blue, white, red.
Okay, you rushed by blue and white. So I'm going to get rid of red, and we just got blue and white. Would you say blue and white?
Blue and white.
Okay. Reverse that. Say white and blue.
White and blue.
Okay. There's a little hesitation on the white. So we're going to get rid of that. So you picked the blue die, right? Okay, good. Whew. All right, so we got the blue die. All right, thank you. This is all just like connection. Just when you walked up, I'm like, you know, a person who hops right up there is going to pick something dynamic like blue. All right. So, and you wouldn't pick red because I've got red on and you're thinking, I don't know, I'm making all this up. But all right, so you rolled a number. What I want you to do is you're going to say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You really, 1 through 3 is gone. It's gone. So we've got 4, 5, 6. 4, 5, 6. So, say, do they know what number you rolled? Yeah? No. Okay. So when it comes, no, that's all right. So when I get it right, you're going to let them know, and then they're going to go wild with crazy applause. All right? Whew. All right. So we got rid of the 1, 2, 3. We got 4, 5, 6. Would you say 4, 5, 6?
4, 5, 6.
Oh, huh. You really rushed. So we're going to get rid of the 6. We got 4 and 5. Say, we're going to reverse it. Say 5, 4?
5, 4.
The way you said that, I think you're trying to get me to pick five. So it was the blue die, and you rolled number four. Yeah? Yeah, all right. Oh, that is amazing. All right, I'm going to look here. Sweet, number four. We weren't in cahoots. Sammy, right? Okay, just making sure. All right, now we are going to move into the next portion. You are going to read my mind. Yeah, you read his mind. You're going to read my mind, all right? So I brought with me, this is actually the last time I did this, someone, I was hungry and I was thinking of pizza, all right? So I'm going to pull this off, and we've got, I'm drawing a crystal ball, I'm on a budget, just like that. It's a crystal ball. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to step over here, and I'm going to think of a thought. I'm going to throw you a thought. It can be a number. It can be a word. It can be a simple picture. You're going to draw it. You can set it down here, or you can just hold it and draw it. And don't draw it yet, because I'm going to send you a thought. Wait until you get my thought, all right? So first of all, I got to put on my thinking cap. All right. So, all right. I'm going to send you a thought. All right, I'm sending you a thought. You getting it? Yes?
No.
Yeah. Okay, so you're writing it down?
Yeah.
Okay, and when you get it written down, before you close it, I want you to show the audience. You got it? Oh, wait, you're over here. Sorry. You got it yet? I would take that as a yes. All right, so is it closed?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to take this off. Let's see. All right, now, here, before we're going to seal this up. That's closed. All right, so what we're going to do is hold this, and I'm going to write what I was sending to you. So it is strange, because what happens is I'm sweating, the lights are coming down on me, and I'm thinking two things. I'm thinking, first of all, this was just a quick thought that came out of my sleeves, because I was thinking, why did I wear so much rope? That was the first thing. Silly. And the second thing I thought was, here, let me, what I thought, and I'm a left-hander, so I don't know if you're going to be able to read this, but one of the things I thought was, not only why did I wear so much rope, but why did I wear my hot blue suit? That's what I was thinking. Did you get it? Let's see. Awesome. All right. All right. So I'm going to have you. You can take a step down. Give Sammy a round of applause. All right. Can you give me the handheld mic? All right, so I need another person to help me. Sammy, would you pick someone near you?
No.
No. you kind of walked into that one. All right, that's okay. All right. Greetings. How are you? Good. What's your name?
Jason.
Jason. My name's John.
Hi, John.
Thanks for coming up. Thanks for volunteering.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Yep, right. There we are. Is that your daughter?
That's my daughter.
All right, good. You'll have one later tonight. That's all right. That's all I'm saying. All right, so we're all talking, I've been talking about connections, the strange connections that we make. And so you read a mind, I read a mind, we did some mind reading and things like that. We're going to try to take this a step further. When I was raised in Southeast Idaho. All right. And one of the things when I was growing up is that one of the things we did for fun was randomly call folks. You know, you're like, hey, is your refrigerator running? You better go catch it. Yeah, I know, really. So, you done that? Great. All right. See, a connection. I kind of knew it. Oh, it's amazing. I got to write that word down. Oh, you know, actually, that reminds me. We're not going to use that word. But if you would name, I have a piece of paper in my pocket. If you would name any word other than whatever.
Homophily.
Thank you. If you name another word, I will have that word written on a piece of paper.
Any word?
Any word.
Grape.
Grape. Nice. I like that. That's neat. Here, we'll... All right. Let's see here.
What? What? So I cheat.
Okay. So we make connections. I call up folks and say, hey, is your refrigerator running? We're going to try something like that, all right? We, as a group, we're going to create a playing card, and then we are going to create a number, and we are going to call someone and see if we can make a connection far away, all right? So, yeah, so we're going to start off, and you're going to be the part, you're going to be talking to this person.
Great.
Because that way I'm not guilty. Anyway, and that's so over here, red or black?
Black.
Black, okay. Red, we got black. Do we want high cards or low cards?
High.
High cards? All right, high cards. We got black and a high card. Do you want, I'm going to say 8 through 10 or Jack through King?
Jack through King.
Jack through King. All right, do you want Jack, Queen, or King?
King.
King. So we have black card, we've got a high card, a King, and since we were reading your mind earlier, spade or club?
Spade.
Spade. We have a King of Spades. All right. So now we got to create a number. All right? Because we got the phone here. We are going to create a number. And what I'll do, so I'll have you hold that.
Sure.
Would you give me three? Wait, we'll pull that out. Yeah. Thank you. Would you give us... let's call Idaho. So 208 is the area code. All right. Would you give me three numbers to start off with?
947.
All right. Would you give me two numbers?
1-2.
1-2. All right. And would you give me the other two numbers?
3-4.
3-4. Okay. All right. So, and then here, put speaker on.
Yeah.
That's all right. And then I'm going to hold this up. Oh.
Your call cannot be completed as dialed.
Or is this on?
Test, test.
Oh, it is. Okay. All right. Okay, we're going to try it again. All right. Do the 208. All right. Would you give us three numbers?
666.
All right. We're going to go with 1-6. I'm not calling there. So we'll go 1-6. All right. So we're
going to 1-6.
1-6. All right. That's all right. That's all good. That's all right. And keeping me on my toes. Holy cow. Now I'm really sweating. Taking a drive down below. So 6. Give me two other numbers. 7-8. 6-7-8. All right. Would you give me two numbers?
4-5.
4-5. And would you give me two numbers?
2-3.
2-3. All right. So we got there. All right.
Speaker?
Yeah. Speaker? Oh, yeah. All right. And let's make sure it's up. Okay. Can you guys hear that?
Yeah.
Hello? Hey there. Don't hang up. You're not being punked. We're not calling you to ask about a refrigerator running or anything like that. My name's John, and we're here in Portland, Oregon, and I'm in a magic show, and this is live. Do you have a moment to help us out?
Sure. Yeah. What's going on?
I'm here with. What's your name?
Jason.
Would you say hi to Jason? Sorry. Who are we talking to?
My name's Nick.
Okay, so Nick and Jason. And would the crowd say hi, Dalen?
Hi!
Yeah. You got that? All right. So we're here, and I know this is really weird, but just go with us. What I've done, it's a magic trick. You're helping out. This is probably going to be the weirdest thing that's happened to you probably this year, I hope. We...
I
what was it? Say that again? Oh.
I want to see the magic trick.
He's FaceTiming us.
Put
on. Whoa. Oh, hey. Would you turn and see?
Hey, I'm Jason. There's the audience.
Oh, holy cow.
There's John right there.
Hey there.
Hi. Hi. How's it going?
All right.
I'm good.
Yeah. Okay, good.
Where are we?
Yes.
Oh, all right. You're on the toilet?
That's, yeah, I'm, thank you for, oh, okay, there, he's in shorts. Thank you for showing us that.
Yeah, thanks.
All right, okay, good. All right, there we are. So it was Nick, right?
Nick.
Okay. Sorry. We have randomly made up a card. We had people over here pick a part of a card, people over here pick a part of a card. You know what a playing card is, right?
Yeah,
a deck of playing cards. I don't want to assume anything. All we need you to do is you're going to name a playing card.
Yes. Any card.
Just name
any playing card, yes.
Okay, I got one. Are you going to tell me what I'm thinking?
No, you're going to tell.
You're going to tell us what you're thinking.
Oh, I'm going to tell you. King of Spades.
Nick, look at that. That's fantastic. Oh, man. Thank you. Oh, man, that is awesome. I'm going to hang up because I've got one more trick to do here, but thank you so much for helping us. By the way, is your refrigerator running? You got to go catch it. So, all right, okay. Thank you. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Thank you so very much. Would you help me out with another trick? Okay, great. We'll pull that out and then give you this. All right. So one of the connections that we have as human beings is this bag. People don't realize it, but this bag is my single sock bag. It's an amazing, a magical thing where I can put a pair of socks in a washing machine, put them in the dryer, and
I'm having my wife make sure she's listening.
Yeah, okay, yeah. I really two a pair goes in, and only one comes out.
Yes,
it's an amazing thing. So we are going to we did a couple of psychic experiments. We are going to try to do the psychic sock sorter. Yep. So what I'm going to do is you're going to pick a sock. First of all, I've got a couple of socks in here. This is my business as usual sock. You know, when I'm trying to be important. This is my sports sock, my exercise sock, because this body just doesn't do stuff by itself. Yeah. And Scooby-Doo! All right, okay. Now, what I'm going to do is you're going to close your eyes and you're going to reach in and you're going to grab one sock. All right? Okay, got it? All right, great. I'll give you that. We don't need that anymore. All right, you can open it up. Ah, sweet, Mr. Rogers. It is a beautiful day in the neighborhood. I like that. All right, so we've got Mr. Rogers here. I'm going to, we'll take this out. And I'm going to, I'll just put this right here. Now, I have here six boxes, all right? And we're going to whittle them down with one of these. What I want you to do is you're going to help me out. You're going to take this and you're going to roll it, and we're going to whittle it down. So you're going to give it a roll, not into the onion. Okay, one. All right, so the first one is one. We pull this off. Oh, look at that. It's a perfect Portland sock, pothead. But it's a coffee pot. All right. So we're going to have you roll again. Six. All right, six. Pull off six. Oh, look at that. Bring me coffee. You're noticing a theme here. There we go. Bring me coffee. All right, we're going to have you roll again. Here, I'm going to get out of the way. Four. Pull up. Four. Hey, look at that. Death before decaf. All right, I love that. That's pretty awesome. Here, we're going to pull this here. All right, another roll. We've got three more. One, roll again. One, roll again. One. One. Two, look at that, two. Another good Portland sock, Sasquatch.
Wow,
look at that. Riding Sasquatch. Okay, now we're going to roll. Five. Oh, look at that. Five. Let's look at five. Holy guacamole. I'm going to be able to, I'm going to be able to sort all those together. Okay, so I'm going to give you these. And we don't need the die anymore because we've rolled. We are left with one box. I know, thank you very much for, whoosh, I know, it's like a dance.
It is.
Thank you.
Like your dance.
Thank you very much. I know. I'm going to say that's a compliment.
It is.
Good, thank you, thank you. All right, we got one more sock. I sent off, could you grab the Mr. Rogers socks? Thank you. We need that because this is going to be a fantastic thing. Three, you rolled the dice, we whittled it down to three. Thank you, Mr. Rogers. Let's see here. I'll hold this and you can actually unbox this so people don't think I'm doing anything funny or sneaky. What do we got?
Happy clouds.
Happy. Mr. Rogers and happy clouds. Bob Ross and Mr. Rogers. Oh, wait, actually, it is kind of a, they are kind of joined. I mean, they're both were on PBS. They're both white Caucasians that Portland loves. I mean, there we are. Everybody loves Mr. Rogers and Bob. Oh, you know, I'm going to have you hold this. I knew there was a reason. So we got the Spider-Man, but when we unmask Spider-Man, on this side, I've got Bob Ross. There we are. And on this side, I've got Mr. Rogers. And you know, as Bob Ross would say,
we make mistakes here. We just have happy accidents.
All right. Thank you so much for coming up. All right. Thank you. All right. And that is my show. Thank you very much.
Keep it going with John Stevens. You got it. All right. How was that?